So many things were destroyed by the tornado. While most of it can be replaced, photos cannot.
And one woman is opening up her photo studio in hopes that something that the tornado took away can be given back. KOCO's Kim Passoff is live tonight in Moore. Kim?
Well, Paul and Jessica, so many neighborhoods look just like this one, flattened, now just piles of debris. But among that debris, you can find thousands of photos just like this one. But then the question is, where do these photos come from? Who are the people on these photos? Who is that little boy? Those are the questions that one woman is trying to answer.
That could be someone's mother, grandmother, sister.
These are people's memories. They're irreplaceable.
If a picture can say 1,000 words, then here are 1,000 stories. A young boy coyly holding a flower. A girl riding her new bike for the first time. A toddler on Santa's lap.
It looked like a 1950s wedding photo.
Amy Pierce, owner of Studio Innovations Photography, found this photo in front of her business in downtown Moore. After the tornado tore through town, she knows it's an important part of someone's life story.
Just broke my heart just knowing that these are somebody's wedding pictures, you know.
She began to collect other photos found on sidewalks and in grass and now has more than 1,000. She also found this, the veil in the wedding picture.
Those were meant to be found and brought together.
I'm glad that I was able to get those back. Those are irreplaceable.
This is a picture of Sarah Brown's home across from the Warren Theater before the tornado, taken on her iPhone. And this is after. She's 5 months pregnant and has lost nearly everything, but found in the rubble her ultrasound, the first memory of her first baby.
That's whenever I found out I'm having a little girl.
She says she was overjoyed when the photos were returned to her and thanks anyone who helps return these precious parts of someone's life before the tornado changed it forever.
I think that they are small-scale heroes.
And certainly all of the volunteers deserve recognition. Now, Amy has teamed up with an organization called the National Disaster Photo Response Organization. They returned some 16,000 photos to people after the Joplin tornado. Now, if you would like to take part in Amy's effort of returning photos to people, we have more information on our website, KOCO.com. Reporting live in Moore, Kim Passoff, KOCO 5 News.
Kim, thanks. It looks like we're going to have to do that. Our crews have gathered these photos
all
out
kinds.
In the fields. I mean, just photos that are ripped apart. They have mud on them. But you know what? You can still see children's faces and their smiles. And these are people's memories that you know they're going to want back.
Like Kim said, all a part of someone's story.
Yeah, part of someone's life. So
really
go to KOCO.com if you yourself have found some photos as well, or if you're looking for some too.
That's right.